This is your weekly trip to paradise, Louisiana style, with Gary Risponi. Paradise, Louisiana is also brought to you by Baton Rouge Coca-Cola Bottling Company, Benny's Car Wash and Oil Change, CCA Louisiana, and the CCA Louisiana Star Tournament, DEMCO, and by Farm Bureau Insurance.
Welcome to this week's edition of Paradise, Louisiana. Here we are back at Superior Bait and Tackle. We've been doing a lot of traveling. Before I get started, you know, go Tigers. Congratulations to the Lady Tigers. Getting ready to go to the Final Four. First time in 2008. I followed them other teams back then, and all I can say is we're going to pray for you. You've already exceeded expectations, and good luck, girls. Go Louisiana. God bless Louisiana. Now God bless Louisiana State University. Baseball team is doing pretty good. You know, softball team came better. So the sports that we all love has also caused me to miss some trips in the outdoors. But the major problem has been family affairs, my kids, my great-grandkids, all of them playing ball. I'm trying to get it all in. I just didn't get to make one of the big events I've been doing for 20-something years at Big Bass Rodeo in New Orleans City Park. I got a report from there, and we told y'all last week it was late coming in, but that Caney Lake, the high school hog fest, exceeded expectations. You talked to Tommy Abbott, so stay tuned. We got a good, pretty good fisherman board. We're back here, Superior Bait and Tackle. Don't forget to come here, check them out, find out the latest baits, get your reels fixed, your rod wrapped, whatever you need. Superior Bait and Tackle on Seguin Lane.
Hi, I'm Nolan Perry, and I just took care of Mr. Gary Risponi here on this beautiful 2018 Ford Expedition.
Right up in Interstate 55, right here, as soon as you get in Mississippi, Tylertown, Mississippi. Here's where it's at. It's a short drive, but it saves you a lot of money.
We're at 108 Old Highway 98 East in Old Tylertown, Mississippi, 39667. Perry Brothers Ford.
This is Don Dubuque asking you to join me as a member of the Coastal Conservation Association. For 30 years, CCA has worked in Louisiana to conserve our incredible fisheries, making sure that our fishing is great today and for generations to come. Whether looking out for redfish and specks, eliminating gill nets, building reefs across the coast, or work at the state capitol and in D.C., CCA is doing what's best for the fish and the sport we love so much. Your $30 membership will ensure that this work and our great fishing endures well into the future. Go to CCALouisiana.com and join CCA today.
I'm Brett Favre. As a quarterback in the NFL, if I didn't stay focused, I ended up on my back or worse. Even the smallest distraction could make a good play or offensive drive come to an end. When you're in a car, the smallest distraction could end much more than a drive. It could end someone's life. Just like I refuse to lose on the field, I refuse to lose someone I love to distracted driving. And you should too. Focus on the road. Don't drive distracted. A message from Farm Bureau Insurance.
Chunky butt right there. That head shake, baby.
Matrix Rip Shad today. Awesome bait. I'll go over why we're using a Rip Shad. As last couple episodes you saw, we were really killing them on that top water, but we changed it up a little bit today. Using a Rip Shad that's doing damage. Starting off with a nice morning. Here's a
another one, baby.
Oh yeah, good fish, good fish. Reason we're using these suspended jerk baits today. Last episode you saw it was slick, slick calm. We had really thick fog, just optimal topwater situation, and it was really good. I started off with the morning here, topwater. Catching it, had a few smacks. They were kind of short striking it. Tied on this jerkbait, and the bites were much more aggressive, much more common. Got a little bit of a ripple, a little bit of a chop today. Kind of the wind's blowing into this cove we're fishing. I know it's a little cloudy now, but we've had some spurts of the sun coming out, and this rip shad is really what they want. Sometimes the topwater's the way to go. Sometimes the suspended jerkbait's the way to go. Right now, the suspended jerkbait's out fishing the topwater by a ton. We're going to go with that, and let's do some damage.
Good. Look at that grass in the water right there. That's what we're doing. We're fishing right over the grass. Like, you see that fish coming right past a little grass patch. Come on up here. We got a good little bite right now. I'm using a purplish colored rip shad. We got a couple purples, a couple golds. We got a clear, all great. Let me show you just the, got a little mess up cast there. Let's try that one more time. We make mistakes too. Not every cast is perfect out here on Dockside TV. But what you want to do, number one, when do you back? You want to, so when you're approaching the shoreline, you're wanting to fish, approach it, set the boat down with the trolling motor, and begin to drift with the wind to your back. It is extremely important because it's going to allow you to cast that lure at a much greater distance. That's the number one thing. Two, when I'm throwing these jerk baits, highly recommend fluorocarbon because these baits are much more effective in very clean water. And fluorocarbon is very important in the cleaner the water. And you don't have to be on grass, just kind of depends on the estuary. Over here off the Pontchartrain Basin, our shoreline, our best shorelines have grass, and that's just what we try to target. And it's been just a fantastic hard bait season this year, guys. We've had a very, very mild winter. Very, very little rain. All of our rivers are extremely low, which means we got warmer winter temps. So the water temps have been sitting in the 60s a lot. That's perfect for hard baits. And with the very minimal rainfall means our clarity's been gin clear, which is great for hard baits, especially the suspended jerk baits. So this has been the thing to do.
As members of a Touchstone Energy cooperative, we've all got a job to do. And the more we work together, the more we save. That's the power of your co-op membership.
Demco, your Touchstone Energy cooperative.
I've been asking him to change the oil for months now, and he never did. So I finally just went to Binny's. They even washed my car for free. Uh-huh. And you know what? It was amazing. Yeah, I left Binny's and got home before Rob even knew I was gone.
Benny? Who the heck is Benny?
Welcome back to Paradise, Louisiana. You know, Canaan Lake, I usually write all these down and I try to do it. I'm going to try one more time to read off the emails I get about the tournament, especially one in Canaan Lake, the high school. They called it the Bass Fest. It was a hog fest, excuse me. But I'm going to read it, and some of Tommy's quotes.
No.
He said they had 180 high school teams, 30 junior teams, and they filed. And by the way, I'm gonna tell y'all now, this coming weekend, they're gonna be at Manshack for the last qualifier for the year. So, and find out where the kids are gonna be going in June and all over the country. And they're gonna qualify for the state and the national. So that usually means one or two things. They found a few committed to the area and were on some fish, but it was unbelievable. This is some of the totals. The juniors started making their way in at 1:30, and it was evident that there were gonna be some big records go. It would start with the few high school division facts. What? 22 fish over 5 pounds. 14 fish over 6 pounds. 6 bass over 7 pounds. 5 bass over 8 pounds, and 4 over 9 pounds were caught. These high school kids now. Top 5 fish limits were caught that went over 17 pounds. 9 of the 5 fish limits were caught that went over 18.5 pounds. 5 fish limits were caught that went over 20 pounds. Now, put icing on the cake, he says, it is that proper high school tournament world record bag of 37.13 was caught by the Bossier Parish fishing team duo of Mason McCormick and Alex Virilio. Now that's 5 fish, 37.3 pounds. High school kids. So Louisiana Lake don't have to take a second place to nobody, especially Toledo Bend and Caney Lake and Boosie Lake. They're all coming in. You know, let's give a shout out to Wildlife and Fisheries and people looking after these lakes. The Lake Authority over there, Toledo Bend. You know, God bless y'all and thank y'all. Now, let me see if I got any other names. It said Mason and Alexis had a day where every single piece of the puzzle went together. Even when an 8-pound bass broke off at the boat, they stood and watched the fish as they returned to the bed. The one that broke off. So it all went good, it said. Now, let me see if we got all the totals here. Thank y'all for being patient. And I can read their writing because it's typed. The tournament once again lived up to the name of Caney Lake High School Hogfest. They had Wayne, they had Wren, they had cold temperatures, but still these kids produced. So, Tommy, thank you for sending me those pictures. And we got a whole line of pictures Chris got to run. Congratulations. That's some kind of high school record right now. So, now, when I come back, I'm going to give you the big bass results of the rodeo at City Park Lake. The big bass rodeo, the annual big bass, one of the oldest rodeos in the country.
I'm Brett Favre. As a quarterback in the NFL, if I didn't stay focused, I ended up on my back or worse. Even the smallest distraction could make a good play or offensive drive come to an end. When you're in a car, the smallest distraction could end much more than a drive. It could end someone's life. Just like I refuse to lose on the field, I refuse to lose someone I love to distracted driving. And you should too. Focus on the road. Don't drive distracted. A message from Farm Bureau Insurance.
As members of a Touchstone Energy cooperative, we've all got a job to do. And the more we work together, the more we save. That's the power of your co-op membership.
Demco, your Touchstone Energy cooperative.
This is Don Dubuque asking you to join me as a member of the Coastal Conservation Association. For 30 years, CCA has worked in Louisiana to conserve our incredible fisheries, making sure that our fishing is great today and for generations to come. Whether looking out for redfish and specks, eliminating gill nets, building reefs across the coast, or work at the state capitol and in D.C., CCA is doing what's best for the fish and the sport we love so much. Your $30 membership will ensure that this work and our great fishing endures well into the future. Go to CCALouisiana.com and join CCA today.
Hi, I'm Nolan Perry, and I just took care of Mr. Gary Risponi here on this beautiful 2018 Ford Expedition.
Right up Interstate 55, right here, as soon as you get in Mississippi, Tylertown, Mississippi. And where is that? That's a short drive, but it saves you a lot of money.
We're at 108 Old Highway 98 East in Old Tylertown, Mississippi, 39667. Perry Brothers Ford.
Introducing Powerade Ion 4, complete with four electrolytes lost in sweat.
Welcome back to Paradise, Louisiana. Welcome back to Spirit Bait and Tackle. What we're going to do now is the Big Bass Rodeo. I told you, the first one I missed in 20-something years. Always a fun day. It's a lot of traffic, a lot of people. I heard it was good. The weather held up. I got some reports from people that fished it and long-time people have fished it. They were looking for me. Thank y'all for calling me and saying, where you been? You all right? You everything. I just had conflicts this year and I couldn't do it. And one of them was, like I said, a lot of family, kids' birthday, great grandkids, special occasions, weddings. It's just been top one after another. So family always comes first. Now, the Big Bass Rodeo, I got some results, but I want to give a shout out to Luke Balin. You know that it's spelled B-E-S-L-I-N, and we a joke on them. For years I pronounced it, but it's French, and they say Balin. So, and that's him. He took first place in the Boats on the Bayou, the kayak division. He had 6.58 pounds, and it was 21.75 inches long. And second was Kalen Johnson, another legendary kayak fisherman, fishes all over the country and the world. And I've been trying to get Kalen on TV and do a little segment with him and tell you how he puts in this. His job, he's an engineer, he's smart as a whip, and he don't leave nothing to chance. So congratulations, y'all. I'm gonna read these off now. Y'all be patient with me. I'm gonna read these off now. This Boats on the Bayou. This is other different categories. I told y'all the bass one. This is the Rio Grande. First place was Wilfred Adams. Second place was Dion Chauvin and Grace Adams. I'm not gonna give it the bass category. I just with the K. Floran Award was Luke Balin. And Kalen Johnson and Diary Smith. Battle of the Bass, first place, Brother Martin. Miracle Workers, Henry Dotrieve, Hudson Camarada, Ethan Desiree, and Nathan Wellman, Connor Pham. Congratulations, Brother Martin, second place. Eco Classic, third place was Archbishop Rummel. Big Bass Rodeo, and Chile and Brim Trim team event was first place Team Camo. They've been there every year. Second place was Team Cream. And third place was Team Henderson. Champions Challenge category, first place Douglas Blanda Jr. Angler. First place was Remy Karras. And junior angler bass category was Paul Kelman Award to Daylon Smith. No, the Paul Kelman Award, Daylon Smith. He had 2.70. The other bass category, first place was Joe Corsell Award, Justin Landry, 6.26. So, and let me give you another report before I can stop. Don't forget, it's starting to get warm up in the 80s. 3 days in a row, well over 80, 84, 85. Don't forget this. Don't forget your water. Don't forget your Coca-Cola products and your Powerade and whatever you do. If you got diabetes type 2 like I do, they got the zero drinks. They're delicious and they work. Don't forget. And I'm going to thank them because they're always there with us. With all of the kids' events, they always sponsor. Coca-Cola always sponsors these daggone events for people. So now, the fishing report, I'm going to go to saltwater still. All the reports I'm getting from Miss Angie and them at Allen Marina and from Mike Brantley, they still catching fish. They're watching the weather. And for a while, a few of them had trouble getting shrimp, but they're back. Couple places, I don't know, they had trouble with shrimp dying, but there's shrimp, but there's a lot of fish being caught on plastic, so the redfish have been a constant. Even down in Venice with the river up, the bass have slowed down, but offshore, when they can get out, they get a good north wind sometime, and it ain't that strong. They're catching wahoo, they're catching every kind of fish you can imagine, so they're offshore fishermen. Now, that's not a first-hand report, but right now in Golden Meadow, this time of year, they're running out to the lakes, they're fishing these canals, and they're catching fish. They're catching them under cork and catching redfish, but the speckled trout, when they can run out to the coast and they can run out to the islands, they are catching fish. Now, islands are starting to clear up and they're being fish being caught in the chandelier hours. If you saw Kevin Ford and them, they're going there. And a lot of those people stay on them boats out there or them lift rigs and they fishing. So Venice right now is still worth going down. The river's muddy, but they're catching catfish. They're catching redfish out of Yan Yan. And if you find that water mixing at certain times, you're going to catch trout. Now, That's my saltwater report. It's a little short right now, but the freshwater, Toledo Bend, Saccolay is still hot. All I have to tell you is that my friends are sending me these pictures. He's fishing under a cork. He was fishing in the north end. Dwayne Chapman sent me a picture. He said I was by myself. I know you don't just don't like a box shot without the fish, but the only way I could do it was by myself. I couldn't take it. I had long enough on. He sent me those pictures. Thank you, Dwayne, for doing that. Fishing by itself. That reminded me of the joke. The most lonesomest place on the water here in Louisiana, you know where that's at? By yourself. That's very lonesome. So I just want to say that. Some people might laugh, some people say they're being crazy. But Dwayne Chapman, he was fishing under a cork with a black and chartreuse jig. He was on the north end, Circle Drive, if y'all know where that is. Because I've been getting different reports. Some people say down south they don't have grass no more. I don't know where they're sacking or catching these fish off the treetops or whatever, but they do report, I tell you exactly where to catch him. He was fishing off the cypress about 3 foot deep, and they're fishing under a cork with a black and chartreuse jig. So Dwayne, the other reports I'm coming, the spillway has been up and down. I didn't get no words. Somebody snuck me a report and said, don't tell everybody, Mr. Responi, but I was in the spillway. We were north when we found a canal. The water was moving out, and we caught a bunch of saccolay. Now, the saccolay bite should be on. The moisture's got to be good. When the rivers start falling, I don't care how high it is, there's going to be places that water's mixing, you're going to catch fish. whether you want to spend the time and drive all over there, or you want to just wait and call your local bait shop when you cross across the river, and you ask them what they're selling cricket, you know the Bremer bite. If they're selling shiners, you know the Sackler bite. So, you know, you can always go to these bait shops and shops like this and get these reports. Chaz, on his website, I mean, he gonna give you every report you want to know. He pinpoints. He shows you picture where he's at. You can't beat that. Same thing with North Shore Fishermen. All those papers, those guys, they got their website and they got their look. And right now, I'm just gonna call all their names because I didn't write it down. But all those people that do it constantly, they are the best source in the world. The newspaper's still good with Joe Macaluso. And that's my last one. I'm going to have to send some pictures. Joe Macaluso, he's been going around the bush. He's been going with Steve Fontana. They're going to False River. My son then went to False River. They didn't find out the pattern till it got later, and they still caught 7 fish and kept 4 or 5 good ones or missed some. They should have had 7. That's what it was. But I caught him when I found out that Steve and Joe, and they had about 8 fish, and they were tournament-sized fish, and they took a picture. So you'll see that in the picture. Thank you, Steve, for telling me, but you've been promising to take me over there. The pattern at False River right now is match to hatch. They got a lot of shad running in shallow water, and different all those areas around the old yacht club, back in the flats where you do find some grass, or you do find some things, or where they got a big drop, or the old ditch is going back into the canal. They throwing a spinnerbait, blue and white, but he got a special color, Steve. They build them, they put their own skirts. Sometimes they put a swim bait on it. But when he told me that, I told my son, I said, get a Smokey Joe rattlestrap, or anyone, or a chrome and blue, and so that's where they find up and catching a few of them, or even a crankbait, a shallow running crankbait. They imitate those shads, the shad colors. You look to the shad, see the spots. That's it. That's the False River report. Lake Verrett getting ready to turn on. The catfish are everywhere in Lake Verrett area. The same thing I'm hearing about catfish in the Mississippi River down in Venice. So. Catfish is a good thing to eat. We got Good Friday coming up. You're going to have a lot of fish. You're going to have Lent still going on. Have a great week. Don't forget to thank God for what we got here in Louisiana. There's been some tragedy that happened this week with our police department. We're still losing officers. Put your family in your prayers. And keep Louisiana in your prayers. God bless Louisiana. See you next week.
Paradise, Louisiana is also brought to you by Baton Rouge Coca-Cola Bottling Company, Benny's Car Wash and Oil Change, CCA Louisiana, and the CCA Louisiana Star Tournament, Demco, and by Farm Bureau Insurance.